Hey friends, welcome to my channel Dental Edge. I'm Dr. Bhanachuk. Today I'll be covering a very commonly asked topic, that is a radicular cyst. So let's get started. But before that, if you're new to my channel and if you want to learn dental topics in a very simplified manner, do subscribe to my channel and click the bell icon so you don't miss anything. Now let's get started with today's topic, that is a radicular cyst. Now, this is the part 2 of the topic, which includes histopathologic features, treatment and prognosis. I have already uploaded a lecture on part 1, which includes the introduction, pathogenesis, clinical features and radiographic features. I'll recommend to see the part 1 as well. I'm mentioning the link for the same below in the description box as well as here upon the screen. Coming to the histopathologic features, we'll see the histopathologic features in 3 parts. As you know, parts of cyst, there is a lumen, epithelial lining and connective tissue wall. So first let's see how is the epithelial lining of an radicular cyst. It is usually stratified squamous epithelium. What do you mean by stratified squamous epithelium? Stratified means multiple layers, squamous means flat cells. So there will be epithelium of multiple layer and thickness is variable, majority times it is 6 to 20 layers thick. This epithelial lining, it may be discontinuous over areas of intense inflammation. Now, sometimes it may show arcading pattern. What do you mean by an arcading pattern? This is an arcading pattern. A series of arches employed for decorative purpose. This is the meaning of arcade. So, the epithelium, if you can appreciate in this image, it will show a kind of arcading pattern will be seen. This arcading pattern is not present in all cysts, especially it is present in early stages when it is proliferating. In later stages, it becomes quiescent and it is usually stratified squamous epithelium without arcading pattern. Sometimes you may also see presence of mucus cells or ciliated cells in the epithelial lining. This is a metaplastic change. And one very important thing is Rushton or hyaline bodies. These are seen in about 10% of radicular cysts. This can be of viva quotient, it's very important. You should know what are Rushton or hyaline bodies. They are called as Rushton bodies because they were first described by Rushton. Now, these are tiny linear or arc-shaped bodies, hairpin-shaped, usually associated with epithelial lining, amorphous in structure, eosinophilic in reaction, and brittle in nature since fracture in some cases. So what I mean is, in the epithelium you will see presence of arc shaped, hairpin shaped, linear or curved bodies. They will be eosinophilic, that is pinkish in color. These will be seen, if you can see in this image. Their origin is unclear and they are thought to be of odontogenic epithelial origin or hematogenous origin. Coming to the features of the connective tissue wall, we have already seen the epithelium. And this is the connective tissue wall of the cyst. Let me zoom it and show you the connective tissue wall. So the connective tissue wall, it is mature collagenous. There will be collagen fibers. Many fibroblasts are present. If you can appreciate, these are the fibroblasts. Then inflammatory infiltrate and usually lymphocytes are most prominent. Plasma cells are also seen to variable degree. So there will be many lymphocytes. These are the lymphocytes and plasma cells may be seen. RBCs and areas of hemorrhage are also present, and you may also appreciate cholesterol crystals. Now, what are cholesterol crystals? This can be a viva question. They are not seen in all cysts. Now, cholesterol crystals, basically, as I told you, the RBCs and areas of hemorrhage are there. Due to breakdown of these RBCs, cholesterol is released into the connective tissue wall. So there may be presence of cholesterol crystals in the connective tissue wall. Now what we see on the slide are cholesterol clefts, that is, these are the cholesterol clefts. Basically, these are the spaces in which cholesterol was present. During preparation of the slide, the cholesterol is lost and we see spaces, slit like spaces, which are called as cholesterol clefts. So they may be seen in the connective tissue wall. You will draw like these are the cholesterol clefts. They are either seen in the connective tissue wall, they may extend into the cavity, and they may also be present in the cystic lumen. One more thing that is important is you will also see presence of multinucleated giant cells. And these multinucleated giant cells, if you can appreciate, these are the multinucleated giant cells. These are usually present near the cholesterol crystals. Why? Because the body behaves as this cholesterol is a foreign material, and to extrude it, multinucleated giant cells are present around the cholesterol clefts or cholesterol spaces. So what all will be there in the connective tissue wall? It is mature collagenous, fibroblasts are there, inflammatory cells, especially lymphocytes and plasma cells may be seen. Sometimes RBC in areas of hemorrhage are seen. Cholesterol crystals are there, but we see cholesterol clefts and multinucleated giant cells around these cholesterol clefts. These cholesterol, it may also be protruded into the cystic lumen. Coming to the lumen, it will show fluid with low concentration of protein. It is palely eosinophilic, sometimes brown due to breakdown of blood. Also, as I told you, the cholesterol, it may be extruded into the lumen of the radicular cyst. So sometimes great deal of cholesterol or yellow mural nodules of cholesterol may project into the cavity. They impart a shimmering gold or straw color to the cystic lumen fluid. Rarely, little amount of keratin may be present. Coming to the treatment and prognosis, extraction of involved teeth and periapical tissue curettage. Once you remove the tooth, you should always curette the area properly to remove the lesion completely. Then sometimes RCT with apicectomy of cystic lesion, that is the lesion, the soft tissue lesion is removed along with the apex of the tooth. Then root canal filling is done. This way you can preserve the tooth. It does not recur if proper surgical removal is done. Sometimes if remnants are left behind, like epithelial remnants or granuloma with epithelial remnants, a residual cyst may develop within months or years later. So friends, we are done with the histopathology, treatment and prognosis of radicular cyst. Do check the part 1 as well so that you are prepared with the complete topic of radicular cyst. Also, if you have any feedback or suggestion, do let me know in the comment box. Also friends, it takes lots of effort to make such videos. Your one like can give me lots of encouragement. So do like my video, subscribe to my channel and keep watching. Thank you.